Cavatelli. Cavatelli. But we always called it Cavatelli. My recipe is for cheese Cavatelli. I'm going to use equal parts of whole milk ricotta. Don't use part skim. They will be disgusting. Part skim is like loaded with water. Okay, so you use whole milk ricotta. It's not ricotta out in brown, it's ricotta. Okay, so we're gonna use the ricotta and flour in equal proportions. Each pound of flour and ricotta you use, you put one egg in, one whole egg. So I'm going to use all-purpose flour. I'm going to use good all-purpose flour. And I'm not going to put semolina in it, but I am going to lay semolina down on the tray when I start to form them. So I hope you enjoy this video. This makes me think of all my grandmothers and aunties and cousins and my mother. We sit around and make mountains and mountains of this stuff. I mean, like 4 or 5 times a year. I would say we all got together, maybe 4 times a year, and made tons of pasta, including these. My dad lovingly calls them sinkers, because when you make them with just flour and water, they're like lead in your belly. But these are lighter and fluffier, and I think more delicious. So all the ingredients are the cheese and the flour, all-purpose flour, and an egg. Pound of flour, pound of cheese, one egg. I'm using Bob's Red Mill unbleached all-purpose white flour. Okay, and I'm going to dust my board, my tray, with Bob's Red Mill semolina flour. No, they don't promote me. I am not monetized. I do not take promotions. Why? Because that's not what I started YouTube for. I'm supposed to be collecting recipes for my relatives. My kids, my grandchildren. Anyway, no salt, no oil, no water, no nothing like that. You think of deals a funny pronunciation? Did you ever get embarrassed when you went to the store and said, hey, I have a half pound of gabagool? And the girl said, we don't have that. I said, yes you do, I'll take the hot. She goes, what? Gabagool. And then I realized where I was. Okay, capicola. Now I'm going to weigh out a pound of this cheese. So here's my egg and my cheese in the food processor. It's done. So I rolled it out into a lock, and here it'll sit for an hour or so. You can try it after 20 or 30 minutes, but I'm going to let mine go for an hour or so. So you just cut a little hump off, flour it. This is really wet. Make a snake. I'm gonna have to just make a couple of this so you can see how we did it. Hey, compare, ci posso suonare, chi si suona un violino, è come si suona un violino. La trombetta zinga zingu violina plinga plingu mandolin tu 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 saxofona tu frisca lette ti piti ti piti ta hey compare ci va a suonare.
Oh, I'm gonna make the Duddie, but I don't have one of those machines. We don't need it. I mean, we never used a machine when we were kids. I'll show you how when I get to the end of these. Gee, Duddie, I really want to make those. I don't have those Cavatelli machines. Neither did I. Here's how I did it. Just take a little piece. Put it on the board. Ta-da! See? Perfect. I'll show you again. Take a little piece, put it on the board,
There you go. Oh, Duddie, I don't have one of those boards. Well, neither did I until about 3 years ago. I'll show you what I did. Okay, so you take another little piece. And this is difficult to do because the fork's going to move. I don't think I can do it. All right, you put it there and roll it down the fork. And of course, whoops, two hands would certainly work a lot better. So you roll it right down that fork. Where are you? Okay, perfect. I don't have a fork that turns that way. Okay. All right. Turn it pointy part up. This is very hard to do this way for me. See? Fork rolled. Works great. Oh, Duddie, I don't have a fork. Do you have one of these? Okay, let's see. Can you see what I'm doing? Perfect. Perfect. It's still perfect. Duddie, I don't have a knife. Okay, I'll show you one more. This is how I started. This is how I made the very first Cavatelli ever when I was maybe 4 years old. Okay, maybe three, I don't know. You take a lump of dough, you just, no cutting, you just kind of flicked it off the end of the dough and we do this. Okay. A little bigger, but still delicious. Anyway, that's that story. And now I've got my trays in the freezer, and after they're frozen, they're going to be put into air sucker bags from the food saver, and I'm going to just keep them in the freezer. So when you cook them with lots of salted water. It should taste like the last time you went to the beach. You know, when you fell off your surfboard. And that would be the salt that you're imparting to the recipe. Because there's no salt in here because it will set a weirdness factor going off. Anyway. Whoops. Okay. Perfect. But doing it like this brings back so many memories. Hungry hubby even needs some. But he knocked the camera down off of the tripod and I'm afraid to turn it back on. Hopefully, I'll be able to make this video. Whoops. Anyway, that's it. I like the fork ones very much. I use that roll for gnocchi, potato gnocchi. Okay. So, I'll see you when I want to cook them. Okay, into a pot of highly salted boiling water, I'm going to add a whole bunch of Cavatelli. Don't put oil in the pot. It does not prevent anything from sticking together. Because you'd have to use like the whole bottle of oil. Now, be careful with this because it's got so much flour on it. It could possibly foam up and boil over. So keep an eye on it. I'm setting my timer. 10 minutes, but I'm not going to make it cook 10 minutes if it doesn't need it. This is a half a stick of butter and 4 sage leaves. Okay, I'm going to let it get kind of brown, and that'll be what we toss the pasta in. Okay, I'll be back in 10 minutes. Just because they're floating doesn't mean they're done. Trust me. Butter's nice and brown. I'm going to fish out those leaves. I forgot to turn you on. Anyway, that's it. Let's toss it around. And so I've got a little bit of the cooking water in there, and I've got some parm right here. Off heat. That's it. It's ready. Thank you.